めく夜空にひとつ平和の誓いを叫ぶ正義の剣を抜くぞ誓い
Hello, you are listening to Detour Quarry. We are recording from on location from Mount Iwafune Quarry. My name is Red. I'm joined by Mel.
They put their bomb in me.
Yeah. Yeah. Also joined by Brad.
Mirror Man, this is the fifth time you've almost died for show and tell.
He does keep doing that.
Yeah.
That's his thing, is he nearly dies. I'll tell you who else apparently nearly dies is the SGM. Fujimoto also keeps nearly dying. It's that's their relationship. So yeah, we watched the third batch of Mirror Man, which is episode 26 through to episode 38. We, broadly speaking, what we saw was a shift, much more of, because I noted last time I felt a shift, but I wasn't sure it was there. But this time, there's been a real shift from...
Happened immediately.
Immediately. The moment this episode 26 happened, was a shift from Mirror Man to Ultraman Mirror Man. Ultra Mirror Man. The SGM gets annihilated, quote unquote, and they replace themselves
with a bigger budget version.
A bigger budget version of SGM,
we are no longer in our basement. We have our own base. We have our own Thunderbirds playing.
Yeah, we've gone Thunderbirds mode, and now it's just a kaiju. The invaders are now. Communicating with Mirror Man and doing like cackling villain stuff in a way that previously they were kind of doing like body snatchers, like menacing things. But now they're still doing that, but they're doing it while poking Mirror Man, going, ha 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 ha, we're so evil, we're the bad guys.
And head bopping a lot for some reason. That's like their thing now. Did y'all notice that?
Yeah. I did not notice this.
They're always head bopping. It's so weird. It's like they're always grooving.
When you see like their green fish form, they're like bopping their heads.
Oh, right. Yes, sorry. I was thinking of when they're in human form. Yes, you are right.
Yeah. When put What Is Love play in the background.
Yeah. And so yes, we have seen a shift from Mirror Man to now we truly are watching an Ultraman show, and the mixed feelings on account of the fact that I liked the bit of Mirror Man that they got rid of, but is this mostly good Ultraman?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. It's like, it feels like a shame that they just kind of changed it into an Ultraman show, but also it both kind of still has some of that Mirror Man sauce that makes it stand out a bit, and also it's pretty decent, pretty good episodes, even maybe more than the last batch, and also maybe it's at least better than whatever they're trying to do in Ace right now.
Yeah. I don't know.
I think I liked this batch less than the last batch. I think the four episodes I liked in this one were the two-parter, but again, I also thought it was kind of weird they kind of did the same premise for a two-parter back-to-back for some reason. with like, oh no, he's dying, or he's almost dead.
And then, oh no, he's getting launched into the sun.
Yeah.
I think... I can't hate the episodes where they launch him to the sun. That's just fantastic.
The thing that... Like, because I also felt the thing. Like, as soon as I saw that they gave him a color timer, I'm like, oh, it's so over.
Yeah, they gave him a color timer, I was mad. I was like, no! What have you done?
I gotta be honest, I watched, like, episode 26, like, a month ago, because, like, all right, I'm gonna not watch this all in one weekend. I'm gonna stay on top of things. And immediately, I watched episode 26, and they gave him a color timer, and I closed the episode after I finished. Like, well, I'm done, Weird Man, from now. Like, I need a break.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, something you've mentioned about two-parters. There's another... sorry, I have to quickly die.
Ah, right, just like Mirror Man.
I'm just like Mirror Man. So something else that happened a lot all of a sudden is this show's got mad continuity for a Monster of the Week show.
Yeah, it's weird.
There's like so much like stuff getting carried over every year. And it's like, it's like layers on layers because it's like... the white ash, you know, from the, it was like strontium, so now Kagami's becoming Johnny Alpha from the 2000 AD comic Strontium Dog, except he's not becoming Johnny Alpha, he's just dying, and he's also got the you know, they keep coming back to, oh, the time bomb that's in my chest, because he's got a bomb in his chest, that's what
the color timer is for, they put a bomb in him.
Yeah.
So ridiculous.
And you know, then it's like, oh, then the sun episode where he's getting launched into the sun. I briefly was like, where did the kaiju come from that is trying to save him now? And then they were like, oh, it's you from the last batch of episodes. And I was like, oh my god, it fucking is. Yeah. What are you talking about? and there's just a lot. There's a lot. I'm sort of like middling on this. This is like, I'm like, this is fine, but like, I kind of wanted to watch
Mirror Man
deal with like alien invasion schemes.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I feel like I wish I was still going for more of the Ultra 7 stuff with respect to the invaders, at least, even.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than being a bit more like Return of Ultraman, kind
of. See, that's my thing. I don't even want to compare it to Return of Ultraman because I think they've done the extended cast really dirty with this change. I feel like they haven't gotten like any time. His girlfriend, Asako, is like barely in the show anymore.
But she's giving them coffee.
Yep.
Yeah, there is immediately they bring her on, they hire her into the crew. And say, hang on, let me find what it says here. Asuko is co-staff, and Kagami's like, what's that? And everyone's like, that means she's basically a housekeeper, and she brings us coffee and stuff. And she's, like, mad about it. And then everyone has a good laugh, and I'm like, okay.
And she keeps doing it.
Yeah.
That kid's barely showing up these days, I feel, too.
Well, like he can't come over to their house anymore. He can't.
It's in the sky.
It's difficult to visit. They hire Kagami as a full member of the team, but he's like a secret agent. And they buy him a new car, and I'm like, okay. He does, now, we have entered the stage of the show where they start really reusing material in terms of how to transform with reflections, because they keep doing car mirror, and they keep doing camera lens.
They did the knife a second time, I believe, after he stabbed that lady in the back. I'm pretty sure that's how he did it that time.
Mm-hmm.
They do at least throw hands with the invaders a bunch. Like, he does just drown a guy in the lake.
Yes. Yeah. The as always, the highlight of me watching Mirror Man And when I turn down the speed of the video down to normal is when he starts fist fighting people. I'm like, let's go.
When I turn up the speed of an episode, it's nothing personal, Mirror Man.
It's nothing personal, Mirror Man. So yeah, there's an episode where the SGM kills Mirror Man.
It's pretty fun.
That's
my favorite. Those two episodes are my favorite. I like those a lot.
Because they kill an entire housing block and replace them with invaders, and only Mirror Man knows. And he starts, like, you get the shot of Mirror Man tearing out a lamppost and smashing buildings, and it's great.
Yes. It's sort of like, because it's like a more, it's a less, like, alarming version of the Return of Ultraman episode where Goad keeps trying to strangle a child to death.
Destroys an entire town.
Yeah, it's like the distance between, you know, you're a giant person destroying things. You know, it's the way that we can all love Godzilla.
Now, is it that two-parter or the next two-parter where he fucking rider kicks a kaiju and beheads it?
That's multiple episodes. First of all, he does that a couple of times, and then he learns how to do it, which was strange.
I was going to say, for some reason, this reminds me of one of the parts of My Hero Academia I watched where, like...
Yes.
Deku keeps breaking his arm, and he's like, I'll use my legs instead.
Let me control F, MHA. There it is. That's my note, is episode 31, Finisher of Blitz. he's got to figure out how he can fight, despite the fact he has a broken arm. And in all caps, I've got, he's Midoriya from My Hero Academia. he just remembers he has legs, like Deku.
Toei is super eye looking over at Toho, or in Toei being like, oh yeah, you can use your legs to fight.
Can I tell y'all about the episode of this batch that I was like, oh, this is so close to being my thing, but just like the way it ends up going, I was kind of like, it's all right, I guess.
Go ahead.
It's the ship one with all the sea contamination, because they set it up like it's kind of more like an Ultra 7 style mystery, and then it just kind of becomes like a kind of generic superhero hostage situation. But then also, like, they're kind of playing around with, like, contaminating the sea and, like, how that, like, is part of the invaders' plans to, like, you know, take over the Earth or whatever by, like, you know, poisoning the waters first. And I was like, this is, like, so close to being fun, but, like, the superhero stuff just kind of overtook it and made it a little more generic than I wish it would have.
Poison the sea, the thing we're already doing?
Yeah.
I did kind of enjoy the episode, just with, like, you have the drama of, like, her dad is dead, and because there's a woman there, and you know.
And you think it's unhinged that her dad was like, I'm gonna give you this ring that only I can take off.
Oh, we've had weirder vibes, but yes. yeah,
I mean, like that's just a dick move. Sometimes your daughter might want to go on vacation or something.
Shout out to the episode like immediately before this, where like Mirror Man gets trapped in some kid's hat, and then like the kid and like the professor is put in like a Houdini box in the middle of the ocean.
Oh yeah, that was weird.
they continue to have fun with the transformation. There is a moment where
the kid's like he goes to shoot the hat, and he can free Mirror Man.
Yes. There is a great moment where he goes to transform using the car mirror, and someone uses a gun to shoot out the mirror, and then there's like a whole fist fight.
That's how he drowns.
Yes. That's just good. It's still occasionally is got what I want.
I think it'd sit easier with me if we had more episodes in this batch that were kind of like the sniper one. I think what might be my favorite episode of the series is like, oh, he's framed for like murder and is like being, you know, hounded by the police and is in handcuffs.
That is a good episode.
I wish we had more stuff like that. It feels like with the shift to the more Ultraman-y type stuff, we kind of lost that sauce. And I'm craving it.
That episode where he's framed does contain the logical conclusion of the henshin, which is, well, if you're handcuffed, you can't do the motions, and now you can't transform. That's how important the motions are. You have to do the pose. We quickly move past the episode where they kill Mirror Man. Then the next part does, when Fujimoto is like doing his fucking, you know, Victory Gundam charge into the enemy. He's like full on. He's gonna like, and he's singing the theme to himself.
I rewound because I was like, wait a minute, is he singing Mirror Man's theme song, or is that like a different song? I'm like, no, that's the theme song. What the fuck?
Yeah, there's a new ED, by the way, which is nice.
I did notice. Do we have that?
I could just ask Sergix for it, probably.
Yeah. If you could do that, maybe I will slap it onto this episode.
I think I'd prefer it than the actual.
Yes.
It doesn't have any as much shrill whining.
Absolutely. Mirror Man. Is there like much that we want to talk about with Mirror Man?
I kind of continue to have the frustration I expressed last time with this series, where, like, this isn't its fault or, like, Ultraman's fault, but I feel like if I had, like, a synthesis of what this show was trying to do with what the Ultraman stuff at the time was trying to do, I would get, like, the perfect sweet spot of, like, things I want, and that is doubly so now with, like, I really do appreciate that it seems like there's a sense of, like, some progression or, like, continuity to acknowledge, like, oh, like, the status quo shifted a little bit, some of the previous stuff, like, has after effects that are impacted in later, even, like, Monster of the Week episodes. It's kind of fun.
You want to see Moriboshi Dan gradually, like, acquiring injuries.
Yes.
And then getting to the last episode and his boss showing up.
Technically, like, we got that return of Ultraman where Go got increasingly more competent, subtly.
This is true. It's like not a pronounced thing, but it is in there if you're looking.
Ace with the progression of the character leaves.
we had a lot of mid-season character progression for Minami.
Yeah, she progressed to Pluto.
Yeah, she progressed from Earth out of the show.
I think just like how much on like the production side stuff I just saw, and was like, it just seems like the quote unquote hero boom, Toku boom, was like taking off, and so there was a lot of like, we got to change the show to keep up with the ratings, which seemed to be successful for better or for worse.
I hate audiences.
Yeah, just
audiences
like, you know,
mid. Eternally. Never trust them. Never trust an audience with anything.
This is Tsuburaya's "we need to make our shows less interesting than the initial premise we came up with" era.
Yeah.
God.
You want focus-tested shows.
Yeah, they should ignore that. They should have people in charge who simply do not care. But unfortunately, that is not the case. We got sensible businessmen attempting to preserve the company, keep it alive. And I guess they did that. Well done.
The audacity. Do we think that Mirror Man's bomb is going to go off in the last episode?
It should.
Yeah.
I do wonder. I'm curious.
And then Kyotaro walks into frame like, hey, what's going on, guys?
Why?
Yeah. I'm... Yeah, I guess it's going to be more of this until the end. I don't know how many more times they can pull off Mirror Man is dead, but it seems like maybe they can keep pushing that, but I don't know.
Yeah.
we got very lucky with the numberings because we got to the end of this batch and I was like, oh, thank God it didn't end on the middle part of a 2 or 3 or 4 part or whatever the fuck. Thank God everything is resolved so far.
I think this was also the funniest place to start too.
Just immediately, bam.
It worked out perfectly.
Yeah.
Somehow.
Here's one thing. SGM, the actual way they come back and find Kagami again, is great. Big fan.
Oh, the funeral.
Mistaking them for invaders and then takes off Fujimoto's sunglasses and he's like, yo, it's me.
And they get the piss filter as the tractor beam takes up the car.
Yep, piss filter tractor beam.
While I do think I kind of miss the ragtag nature of their first iteration, I cannot deny that the Phoenix is pretty sick.
Phoenix is pretty sick.
I quite like the Phoenix.
I feel like Ultraman Ace does not care about the arrows as much, so.
It's got the arrows, it's got the Falcon, and it's got the space, and I could tell what the arrows are, but if you ask me to distinguish between the space and the Falcon,
I think the Falcon's like the big happening. One.
Falcon's the big one, but when it's a model and they're flying it around, it's probably roughly about the same size on the screen as the arrow when That's they're shooting true. It. So difficult for me to tell personally. I quite like the Phoenix. It's got that Ultra 7 three-part split going on. Yeah. This is some good. They've got some good Thunderbirds happening here. I like their landing sequence.
At least they kept like some Ultra 7-ness when they changed the show.
Mm. But yeah, I don't necessarily have that much more to say about Mirror Man.
There is one thing. I do feel like it was... So remember last time we noted that he was hanging out with kids a lot more?
Yes.
That kind of happens this time around, but I feel like it's a little less, like, Saturday morning cartoon vibe. Like, I don't know. I feel like they actually did a better job with, like, the episodes involving the kids this time. I think that was them trying to find their footing after deciding, we maybe want to go with a different tone for this. So I do think that was at least an improvement, I noticed.
Remember the first batch where one guy did a hit and run, and then he was like, oh, it's fine, it's an alien?
Yeah. 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 The first batch where the sign that guy had gone haywire was when he slapped his wife out in front of the hospital and just everyone around them just like kind of pauses for a second and then just keeps going. That shit was good.
The first batch with the most understood dad of all time.
Which one was
the guy who's like, I can't, my kid thinks I'm dead.
Oh,
but
oh
I'm
yes.
actually alive.
Oh yes. What a wild guy.
You know who else is a wild dad?
Who?
The professor.
He is.
A little bit, yeah.
He's out here. He's out here like the SGM's like, damn, we gotta go find Kyotaro. Meanwhile, like Mirror Man's corpse is in the hangar and he's like, oh yeah, I wonder where he could be.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, them having just the Mirror Man corpse just in the hangar and just like on life support is great. Big fan.
I do think it's funny, just like the shot of them carrying it over.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's like one of those things where it's like, oh, we're probably breaking something by doing it this way, but like what, how else are we gonna move something that big?
You gotta hope Mirror Man is resilient.
Yeah. Maybe Mirror Man doesn't have bones. It's just all glass the way through.
All glass.
Yeah.
The glass superhero.
I did like the touch that he wasn't powered up by the sun. He's like, well, I need another power source.
Yeah.
Because that'd be like, you know.
He's not Ultraman.
He's not Ultraman. He's not a being of light. He's a being of reflected light, which is different. Yeah.
The moon. The This episode was not really remarkable to me, other than the learning how to kick thing. But the episode where it opens and he's just in like a weird fog, and then he finds a kaiju, and then the invader's voice just yells at him, "We hired this kaiju to kill you, Mirror Man." And I'm like, yeah. Hell yeah, let's fucking go.
It is funny. They're just like, oh, Mirror Man's a coward. He's not gonna
do
us. Oh yeah,
is that the one where they bully him on loudspeaker?
Yes.
Yes.
Baby, ridiculous. Mirror Man doesn't want to come fight your kaiju.
That was, I think, one of the big ones for me, where I was like, okay, this is just a different show than what it started as.
Yeah, go ahead.
I was going to say, sometimes the professor's evil, but sometimes he's just smart, where he's like, no, just don't run into things.
What do you mean you agreed to go fight a kite? Shut the fuck. Just stay here. The thing that I particularly like is hired. That opens up a whole new possibility space. You hired a kaiju?
Show me the contract.
Okay. I'll take that.
I like how the one episode is like, here's the dinosaur guy B. He's the younger brother of the other dinosaur guy.
Yes.
I feel something, too, bringing up the professor. I think the earlier parts of the show also kind of had this thing where it was like, besides, like, him hanging out with his girlfriend, that one kid, there was kind of this vibe of, like, ah, yes, it's Kagami and then his three weird dads, Fujimoto, Murakami, and the professor. And I feel like Murakami and Fujimoto have maybe taken a back seat in the new SGM a little bit from that specific role to be more, like, generic, like, defense/attack team members.
Yeah.
Which I think is a little bit of a shame. Yeah.
He's the guy, and also he does keep trying to get himself blow up. Not unlike Kyotaro. I do like that we still have some of the stuff with the professor where he's like, it's probably immoral to use you as the Mirror Man gun, Kyotaro, but I will do it.
Mm-hmm. He feels the weight of responsibility. Yeah. That might be Mirror Man.
I don't think I got anything else. I feel like this one, especially so, kind of speaks for itself in terms of just like, yeah, this is the direction they went with it.
Yeah.
This is different.
Give me a sec.
Go for it.
I got my postscript stuff. And also, I think someone sent an email about Mirror Man, so.
Oh, we'll take an email about Mirror Man.
Sliding with my dog like a Mirror Man.
Alright, so first I'll do the trivia section. I don't think I've ever done the suit actors yet, so the suit actor for Mirror Man from episode 1 to 37 was Mitsuru Saijo. And then for 36, the end of the show is Kenichi Kasumi. I don't know why there's overlap there. Don't worry about it. Then for the kaiju is Shinichi Umeda for episode 1 to 26. Then Michiharu Sakamoto, episode 27 to 51. The episode directors, Toshitsu Suzuki for episode 26. Yoshiyuki Kuroda for episode 27, 28, 31, 34, 35, 38.
Damn.
Shohei Tojo for episode 29, 30, 36, 37. And then Hiroshi Shimura for episode 32 and 33. The writers are Hiroyasu Yamura for 26 to 28, 34, 35, 38. Then Bunzo Wakatsuki for 29, 30, 32, 33, 36, 37. And Ohiro Ando for episode 31. Special effects directors is Nobuo Yajima for 26 to 31, 34, 35, 38, Kazuo Sagawa, 32, 33, and then Yoshiyuki Yamura, 36, 37. All the kaiju this batch were made by Kako Yonatani. I don't know if there's the trivia for the kaiju is even that interesting, to be honest. It's just like, oh, this one's based on this kind of animal or mythological thing.
No.
Yeah, unfortunately, the kaiju aren't necessarily a highlight of this show, which is a shame because it's become more of a kaiju show.
Yeah.
There's like two guys that are We Have Red King at Home in the same episode.
Yeah.
And then they show up again as like their B form or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, go ahead.
The only interesting one maybe is like the one episode where Mirror Man like dies from the SGM, that two-parter. The two kaiju were apparently supposed to have swap designs. Okay. Which is funny. And then
do we know why they swapped them?
A mistake, probably.
Oh, okay.
and then here's like a rough design for one of them, I guess. There's not really much, to be honest.
That's a monster, all right.
It's
a good thing that none of the writers for Shits and Giggles just decided to kill all the invaders permanently in an episode they wrote.
Just unify them all of a sudden, and then you can just fight the unified version of them.
Oh man, Kyotaro has to fight the invader.
Yeah, the invader. The one invader. Quantum invasion. Is that all of the production stuff?
Yeah, that's all the history. That's all the extra bonus stuff I got.
So, did you say we had an email?
Yeah. So, first of all, so this email is by Logan. Technically, this email is for three separate things.
Okay.
So, the email is thoughts on Rising, the next batch of Ace, and the last batch of Mirror Man.
Okay.
One of these I'm going to read next week. One of these I'm going to read now, and one of these I'm going to read in like an hour.
Okay.
So you're going to get, Logan, you're going to get emails getting split up, but also you allude to that kind of in your email. Hi, HQ crew. Yeah. It's Logan again, this time with thoughts on a bunch of toku. I know this email is long, and I'll probably be super newsy the next couple weeks. Hope it's not too bad for you, Mel, since it'll be slow for a couple weeks. That's fine. First up, Ultraman Rising. I'm skipping that. Now for Ace, skipping that. Finally for Mirror Man. At the end of this batch, I was disappointed that the show also had a rework to make Mirror Man even more like Ultraman. But also they think that this batch is the best so far. On one hand, the show, a lot of what made Mirror Man's unique was originally gone. I think how they changed the show was handled much better than Ace. They also seem to be referencing past episodes, which make more than before feels ahead of its time, which I like. Unlike the Ace, the invaders are still active villains, which does a lot to keep it still distinct from Ultraman. And honestly, when I watch the show, all I think about is what Ace could have been if people were handled better. Also, on a side note, I think the show also regretted some of its changes. I think Mirror Man Color Timer just stops being mentioned after a couple episodes. I think he just thinks how he'll explode if he uses too much energy. Question, what show do you think was most harmed the most by its mid-run rework, Ultraman Ace or Mirror Man?
We have yet to see the rest of Ultraman Ace. However, Cold Shot. Yeah. I'm going to say Ultraman Ace just because it really doesn't matter that much how good the rest of Ace is. It will always get knocked down a few rankings for what happened.
Yeah.
Yeah, and also I feel like the Ace one feels much more scorched earth. This feels like a course detour. Detour quarry. The Mirror Man one made me less mad. It was more of like, I'm feeling diminishing returns from what I personally liked about Mirror Man with each of these batches. But like, Aces, I don't think I'm going to sit well with. But again, we have to...
Mirror Man's thing of like the team, the people working on the show, reworking it, because of pressures of the industry versus... You know, Ultraman Ace, we're experiencing the pressures of the industry, and so we have sacrificed one of our actors. Which is worse.
Mirror Man feels like they altered course to make it more generic, but like it's still fundamentally Mirror Man. There's the Mirror Man. There's still Mirror Man elements in it, basically, because like the invaders are still there. Kotaro, even though he's kind of repeating some plot points, still has his like personal foibles and stuff. And meanwhile, with like Ace, it's like, we had a villain. They're gone now. We had a female protagonist who is co-transforming with a hero, and she's gone now. And now it's just, I don't know. Are we just gonna have like worse Return of Ultraman again kind of thing, or you know?
Mm-hmm. I would also say I would take Mirror Man's generic kind of run of the mill episode blow for blow over Ultraman Ace's generic run of the mill episodes like any day of the week. I also just think like when Mirror Man was at its best, I think it's hit higher highs for me than when Ultraman Ace was at its best too. And like I don't think Mirror Man has fallen as far as I'm anticipating from what Ace's change will inevitably result in.
Yeah, I don't want to talk about it too much on the Mirror Man podcast, and maybe I'll probably have more to say on like when we get back to Ultraman Ace. But I was just thinking today, the degree to which, like, even knowing for months before starting the show that, like, the thing happens, when we got to it, it hit me differently than I expected, which I guess is, like, a good argument for, like, spoilers don't necessarily ruin a show. But, like, just, like, oh, I know the bad thing's gonna happen, and I get to the bad thing, I'm like, man, this sucks.
Yeah. Like,
you know?
Mm-hmm. Many people experience this every day as they open up an RPG and say to themselves, I'm going to do an evil run. And then they don't like it.
Yeah.
They should do an evil run in Shadow the Hedgehog.
Yeah, don't be too neutral about it, though. You might get one of the 17 endings where he slaps Robotnik to death.
He's the hero of Shadow, everyone.
You can play that.
I said Robotnik like a 40-year-old. What the fuck am I doing anyway? Yeah.
Damn. You can play that game normal. There are mods to play that game normal now, I think.
Do you think... Are you going to call it Mobius now, Brad?
No. Where's Sally Acorn?
Yes.
Okay. I think...
Yeah. Thank you for your email, Logan.
Yeah, thank you for your email.
We'll thank you again in an hour when we record Rising, and then presumably next week when we actually watch the episodes that you've watched for Ace.
Yeah. Is the... Was, that's the email about Mirror Man.
That's the email. That's the email.
Do we have any last words for Mirror Man, the third batch? Before we part ways.
I mean, every time I say my last words, it comes back.
That's true.
Yeah.
That's true.
I hope the final episode, like, goes hard.
It should.
Yeah, I hope
it feels like the type of show that would end on a banger, you know?
Yeah, I know people like this show, and I want to see what they like in it, so I'm hoping that, like, just, like, the end of the show is better. The one I read, maybe there's, like... spoiling things a bit, but like when I read like the Japanese wiki about some of the retools, it did allude to the idea that like by the time it gets into the third core, the show is shifting toward more of a all-out total war against the invaders, so I don't know, we'll see if that manifests.
It okay. Kind of has that vibe.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Which is, you know, if it goes harder in the finale, that's cool.
Yeah.
And I will. I promise myself I will watch it across a larger time frame.
Yeah,
this is your last. This is your last chance.
This is my last chance. I will. I'll just watch it at work. It's very easy.
Yeah. Who knows when the next episode will be? Because things are complicated right now.
Yeah.
Because like we got.
Yes, this is true.
We got arcs starting soon, but also we're doing that in batches, so it won't be as ridiculous. But also, you know. Mm. We gotta juggle stuff.
We'll see where there's time and or space, yeah. and we will make a decision in the future. We are not telling you now when Mirror Man is happening.
Schrodinger's Blazer movie as well.
Yeah, Schrodinger's Blazer movie. Jesus Christ.
That
Super
apparently,
Gaia.
Like,
where is it?
I did see that is airing soon in the next like week or so in Malaysia, which does have English subtitles, so maybe there'll be one brave soul who will, you know.
Yeah. Fingers crossed.
Take one for the team.
Please. And then the movie's coming out in like July on Blu-ray in Japan. I've heard my friends suggest that like they were waiting for Rising to get out and then eventually they'll put it somewhere, which I guess makes sense because like Rising's probably the bigger movie if you think about it. But also, you know,
well, Rising's out.
We'll talk. Yeah.
So drop the movie. Speaking.
Yep.
Speaking of Rising,
we're
going to be talking about that in a minute.
Yeah.
So if you want to follow the show, you can do so on Twitter at UltraQ. That is at @ultra_QUEUE. Mel.
You can follow me on the websites, specifically Blue Sky, and also X, the website retooled into Twitter from Twitter. That joke didn't land. Anyway, I'm at Dear Crowns.
Yeah, it's been retooled from an alien invasion website into a superhero website. Yeah.
Yeah, there's now a pussy in Biobomb. If you tweet too much.
We have an email, altqpod@gmail.com. Always happy to take emails. And then we also have the fund that is a coffee page, altq fund. Brad, take it away.
Yeah, you can find me everywhere at beinvoked. That's BE_INVOKED. And by everywhere, I mean Twitter and YouTube. There's a small world these days for me.
Yeah. I have a Twitch. You can find it, probably.
Oh, yeah. We stream more Tales of the Abyss. That was fun.
Yeah, it was nice. Nice to pick up again after, like, a couple months away from
Yeah.
I like those guys.
Yeah.
I like the way they feel about each other.
Yeah.
All right. Sick. Join us next time for Mirror Man. No idea when that'll be. Once again, we will announce it closer to the time. You know, keep your ear out, I guess. Yeah. And bye bye. We're gonna go talk about Ultraman Rising.
Yeah. Goodbye.
Later.
Mentioned I because you know it's going to be skipping the queue, I figure we're just going to talk about the movie. I'll mention now I hacked a DSi first thing I'm doing is playing a Professor Layton game because I've never played a Professor Layton game.
Which one?
Curious Village,
of course. I just want to make sure you're doing the right thing.
Yeah. I'm doing the right
thing. I've heard it's very easy to hack the DSi.
Very easy. I mean, here's the thing. It's easy to say it's very easy when you've done it and you've realized how easy it is. It's less easy when you're looking at the instructions and going, wait, what the fuck am I doing? But yes, now that I've done, once I just figured out what the steps were and, you know, then I just did it, I was like, oh, that was very easy. That was extremely easy.
I'm looking forward to you finishing at least one game and presumably more of them, because I want to hear your opinion on what level 5's conception of Britain is.
Of course. We aren't that into puzzles. I'll tell you that much.
Well, that's just him, to be honest.
No, it's everyone in the Curious Village is like, oh, we love puzzles so much. He solved this puzzle with me. And Professor Layton's like, hell yeah, I'll solve a fucking puzzle. Give me that puzzle. And then he doesn't solve the puzzle. I have to solve the fucking puzzle.
My opinion...
That's the video game.
One day I should revisit those games. I've only played... Well, I played the main six. There's a few ones made later that I haven't touched. Mm-hmm. I really like the first trilogy a lot, and I super, super like the third game. Mm-hmm. I'm kind of more down on the second trilogy, but I like the fifth game. Middle one of that trilogy a bunch. And I think the sixth one is trying to do something interesting, but I don't really necessarily like.
Ah.
Everything is. But, you know, I'll... You know, if you go through them all, I'm happy to hear your opinions on them. Because, you know, it's also been, like, years for me.
What I'm doing is... maybe I'll save this. Maybe I'll save this idea. Maybe I'll save this for next week's podcast. Once I've finished a game. And I can tell, I can say what I'm doing.
Okay. A secret for me.
Yeah, I have a project.
I have lots of projects.
This project is good, in my opinion, because it's less a ticking boxes project and more like time travel. And so I'm going to have a great time.
Nice. I need to get back to watching Project of Conan.
How much have you seen two seasons?
I've seen two seasons and a bit of season three. It's just like season three overlapped with exams and then the whole my parents trying to look for job stuff. And so it's just been like, you know, lots of stuff getting in the way. And also it's like, well, I want to also do other things. Mm-hmm. It's just sort of like, well, I want to like be consistent, but I'm also like, well, you know, I need to manage my time is my thing, I guess. Instead of, like, you know, letting executive dysfunction happen to me.
That shit sucks.
That's like the main barrier to me, like, not finishing stuff. If executive dysfunction. The second barrier is me starting stuff, even though I have stuff unfinished, but yeah.
Uh-huh.
That's life.
I'm desperately, desperately attempting not to start any new anime right now. Like, desperately. I really have to resist until I've watched Elgaim. Like, the last things on this list of stuff that I have to take off is I have to watch Elgaim and I have to watch Kuga. And they're both shows I will like when I sit down and watch them. I know I will, but for some reason I keep not doing it. Very silly.
Patrons can listen to this podcast if you subscribe for $10 and up on our Patreon.
This second trilogy of Layton games is a prequel. They're prequel.
Yeah.
Games. Only one of them's on the DS. The other ones. That's why there's the gap of a few years.
Yeah.
A couple of years. Next ones are on the 3DS. Okay.
Yeah. Okay. I never played the one featuring her daughter, his daughter. I know they're making it.
Fucks. No, he doesn't.
No, he doesn't.
Get out of here.
Somehow, he has multiple children, and they're all adopted.
Of course they are. Of course they are. They have to be. He couldn't have sex if he tried.
That's one puzzle he can't solve.
That's the one puzzle he can't. He could fuck if he turned it into a puzzle. He needs to find someone who turn it into a puzzle for him.
Insert the audio of like find the clitoris here. I do think you need to not throw out this audio.
No, I'm keeping this. This is getting preserved. Absolutely.
Somehow. I don't know how you're going to do it, but...
I don't know where I'm putting it.
That's what he said.
That's what he said. Shut up. feel like it's like no. It's okay. This is like taking a pen, like drawing a maze on her.
Can I use my hint coins here?
I do now have, there's the one Penny Arcade cartoon that's the I have 12 matchstick that I am now like, yeah, that is pretty funny.
One of my favorite things, anecdotes about Professor Layton, is when I first played the first one, I got like 6 puzzles into the game or something. It's like one of the very, really like first half hour puzzles. And it was like a geometry puzzle. Where it's like find the length of this like the you know this edge of a triangle or something.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't, for whatever reason, I didn't know how else to solve it than by doing trigonometry. So I did.
Oh, is this the one where like me, you pulled out a fucking calculator, but the actual solution is just it's the radius of a fucking circle, you moron.
Yeah, because it's like really easy.
The line is from like the center. The line is a mirror of a line that goes from the center to the outside of the circle. You dumbass. Yeah,
it seemed like too long, so oh, yes. I don't remember this was a problem. I just remember like used trigonometry to solve a puzzle that was actually really easy.
Yes, that's exactly what happened. Hello, welcome back.
Hi, Brad. We recorded an entire separate podcast on Professor Layton.
And what?
What kind of puzzle would you have to put together to get Professor Layton to understand sex?
Oh. I don't know enough about Professor Layton to answer this. Oh,
there you go. There you go. That's why you weren't on the secret 10-minute podcast.
Yeah. Have fun figuring out where to put that. That's what I'd say before nefariously teaching Professor Layton about sex.
Thank you for making the exact same joke we did.
God damn it!
okay, right.